just as soylent green as people. So the Chintz Age is now. Everything is cheaper and chintzier than in the past. Consumer products with planned obsolescence. Cookie cutter glass and steel architecture. Even culture itself, as mass-produced art, ghost-written bestsellers, manufactured pop stars, and fake reality shows crowd out the genuine article. Among the most obvious manifestations of the Chintz Age has been the gentrification of our great cities, and in particular New York, as rising rents squeeze out the old artists and bohemians in favor of young professionals dissatisfied with the sterility of the suburbs their parents created. New Yorkers carry on a tumultuous love affair with their city, and those of us who've been here the longest may begin to feel neglected, even abused, as our seemingly unfaithful lover fixes upon a new object of affection. But is this changing of the guard necessarily a bad thing? And hasn't it always been this way? As the developers are fond of saying, you can't stop progress. So should we look backward in teary-eyed nostalgia for the glorious past, or grit our teeth and move forward, accepting the inevitability of change in order to carve out a place for ourselves in this brave new